So one of the most important things as a designer is to look at other people's work and try learn from it and maybe adapt on a few things that relate to you and fit it in your style. So in my previous video, I did a deep review of the Xiaomi rebrand. In that video, I promised to come and share with you a deep analysis and what designers can learn from this rebrand. So in this video, I want to share with you what I learned from the Xiaomi rebrand. And it's super important. Like, it's so, so important that you stick around and watch all the way to the end. So this is one of the most common questions that I get from young designers and people who are getting into logo design. Coming up with stories, coming up with convincing stories that can help them sell their logos. And myself, when I was just starting up, I used to struggle with this, and I started realizing that actually it wasn't really that hard. And here's the thing, like when you listen to the story behind the Xiaomi rebrand and how the client bought into this story, I think there is a major lesson there. That stories shouldn't be that complicated. The first thing that stands out in this entire story is how the designer managed to connect the entire, you know, vision of the campaign and the shape. So something simple as a shape can be tied into the entire process of whatever they do at the campaign. So if you can convince the client that this shape fits in well in the vision. For those of you guys who felt like this process of coming up with stories is sophisticated, like this is something that you need to pick from. Like, look at how this guy managed to convince the client and tell them that this, you know, super ellipse represents life, like alive.
最後に映像をご覧ください。この映像は3つのフレームから成り立っています。真ん中は少女の微笑みです。まさに人間の生命を表現した映像。左側は宇宙のリズム、海面が動く姿、月の地平線から昇る地球、まさに人間から遠くにある宇宙のリズムです。そして植物の運動、花が咲いてしぼんでいく、人間とは違う生命のジェネレーションとディジェネレーションを表現したものです。この3つの世界像が融合しながらバランスを取っていくという、まあ、そういう姿はアライブ、生きているという、まあ、今回のデザインコンセプトを表現するものになっています。
Think about it. Like, it's just a shape. How can this tie into life?And when you look at the presentation you buy, like even a designer myself, I was like mind blown. So you need to keep it simple. And in the future, I will share some of the brand projects I've worked on and how I managed to come up with the story to convince the client. So the other thing I learned from this entire process is how shapes are super important and fundamental when it comes to logo design. This is something I've been ranting about on my Instagram page. If you guys are familiar, I've been writing captions that are length, just trying to tell people that every logo designer needs to understand the basic shapes. So in my reality, this was more of a vindication for the process I've been always building around my modern logo design program. Because in the program, I'm focusing my effort on teaching fundamental shapes, on how logo designers need to really first understand fundamental shapes before they go on to get carried away in typography, color, and all the other things. So this logo design process like showed me the power of shapes and the mathematical formula behind this shape that I didn't know. Like, I just came across after I was doing research, and I'm learning something new right there. So for those of you guys who didn't really pay attention, if you're a logo designer, even if you're a designer, like, who doesn't want to learn about like super ellipse? I didn't know that existed. I didn't know even the term existed, but now I know. So it shows you how you really need to go back to the basics, learn shapes, and then maybe, you know, skyrocket your, you know, your experience and start doing things you love. But shapes are super core. Like, when you look at like from a square to a squiggle, that is magic. And for me, it gave me a lot of school of thought, and I'm really right now just, you know, revisiting all the old ideas and, you know, vindicating all the thoughts I had before. So those are the two lessons that I picked from this entire rebrand, and I feel like I have to make a video about this, because yo, this entire thing for me was amazing. Like, this entire storyline, this entire rebrand was amazing. This gives me confidence that the world we're living in right now needs simple design. And simple design means you need to be so simple. Like, whatever you design, it has to be intentional. You cannot include so much stuff on your logo and you think that is the future. That's why I started this modern logo design program, because I feel like right now there's a need to start teaching designers how to design modern logos, because it's a thing. Right now people are so carried away in like IG shorts, trying to create like a quick logo for IG. But I think what you see on IG is not logo design. I feel like there's a step back for you to start learning real serious logo design. So, I mean, that's it for this video. I don't want to really rant about logo design right now, but I just wanted to share the lessons that really inspired me from this rebrand. One, as I mentioned, like, story is not complicated. Like, it's you designers who complicate the storylines of any logo you design. Like, you need to keep it simple. Tap into the client vision, listen to the narrative the client already has, and try maybe build around that. Don't come up with new things. It's as simple as biomimicry. Like, most of the serious innovations have been ripped off from nature. Nature has already done its part, and designers are just there to observe. And I think this is a serious lesson. I'll leave a link for you guys to go read about biomimicry. And there's a video that goes on to explain what biomimicry does and what it is. So I think that's a good lesson for you guys also. You need to read biomimicry if you want to be a good designer, because nature is perfect at whatever cost. You know, the perfect is not like it's super, super perfect, but it's magical the way nature does its thing. Like, when you look at the ecosystem and how technology is adapting the ecosystem, like, they are not even yet a centimeter close. Like, it's crazy. Like, the ecosystem from the real world of the ecosystem is mind-blowing. So technology is just trying to keep up. So every time you see something, try to look with a close eye and try to observe the detail. That will make you a good designer. So the other lesson is about shapes. As I mentioned, like shapes are fundamental. Like, in telling stories, shapes play the role better. Like, I remember when I was pitching the Uganda Securities Exchange, I mentioned how these were stripes representing, you know, the ups and downs in the stock market, because Uganda Securities Exchange, they trade stocks, right? So I was observing all the curves, and I wanted it, you know, to represent that that language of up and down. So that's how I came up with this direction. I remember like when I was pitching it, it related a different story to everyone. So that's the power of shapes. It can really help you tell a better story. And I remember being fascinated how people came up with different ways of narrating different things from the same shape. So before you go, for those of you guys who just landed on this video randomly, super excited to meet you. My name is Paul Zana, and I'm a software designer. I enjoy logo design. I'm starting soon a modern logo design program that is onboarding young talent like you, yourself, even like experts in the industry. I think this is a course that needs to help you go back to the basics and understand what logo design is. And yeah, enough of that. Let me know what you think about the entire Xiaomi rebrand. Share your thoughts in the comment section. I want to know what you learned from the entire rebrand. For all my old guys, my old subscribers, I love you guys. And also, I feel like I'm tired of mentioning this, but I need your support, guys. I want you to become patrons and support my vision. And I'll leave a link for you right here in the screen or in the description. And also, buy me coffee, guys. Like, buy me coffee on weekly. That will do the thing. And yeah, that's it. I'll just go right now. Whew. Let me first check my Instagram before you go. Quick.